Hi, I'm Lucy. Today, I'll be introducing this digital touchscreen oscilloscope. When repairing hashboards, we can use it to detect the ASIC chip's signal waveform, figure out if the chip is working properly, quickly identify faults and fix them. Let's open it up and see what's inside. Two high voltage probes. A compensation capacitor adjustment pen. The product user manual. And a USB data cable. It is a high definition, large screen touchscreen oscilloscope. Here's the analog bandwidth and sampling rate. Here are the dual channel interfaces. Channel 1 and channel 2. Between them is the waveform calibration probe port. Next to that, there are the indicator lights, USB interface, and power switch. On the back, there's a hidden stand, making it convenient to observe the data. Now, we'll choose channel 1 and insert the high voltage probe. Tighten it by turning clockwise, and loosen it by turning counterclockwise. This is the probe's outer casing. Press here, and the probe hook will come out. Attach the hook to the port to calibrate the waveform. Turn it on to enter the oscilloscope interface. Click Auto Adjust to set the waveform to its optimal state. Control switch allows we to select the channel. The top is for channel 1 waveform adjustments, and the bottom is for channel 2. Here we can set the waveform length. When the waveform peaks are uneven, we can use this compensation capacitor adjustment pen to adjust it so that the wave crest is adjusted to a flat state. I will explain the functions of the following buttons while demonstrating them later. Here, the function key can be clicked to enter the system settings. Select Image Browser to view the pictures we saved in screenshots. Click Waveform Browser to view the saved waveform data, which is convenient for further analysis. This is USB sharing, which can transfer oscilloscope data to the computer for later use. CH1 represents channel 1. Select on here. FFT is set to off. Coupling mode is set to AC. The probe multiplier is 1 times for voltages up to 40 volts. 10 times is suitable for within 400 volts. And 100 times is suitable for within 1000 volts. Note that the same magnification as the probe must be selected here. CH2 is channel 2. Next, I will use the hashboard for actual operation. First, let's use this Whatsminer M31S hashboard as an example. For convenience, we extended the probe clips. We choose channel 1 and connect the probe clip to the negative pole of the hashboard. Remember, the probe's casing should only be removed during use, or it could mess with the sensitivity. Before start measuring the waveform, we need to adjust the waveform based on the CLK signal. At this point, we can click Auto Adjust, and it will automatically adjust the waveform to its optimal state. Go to Control Switch and adjust the waveform length as needed. Click on the left or right side of the screen to adjust the waveform's width. After clicking Run and Pause, we can see its running status here. The parameters of the time cursor will be displayed in this position in the upper left corner. The voltage cursor data is also here. For parameter display, just select what we need, and it will show at the bottom of the screen. Its function is to take a screenshot with one click. The last one is to save the waveform to facilitate our later data analysis. let's continue to measure the waveforms of TX, RXD, and RST signals. Once the measurement is complete, we put the probe housing back on. The following, I'll be demonstrate using the Avalon 1166 Pro hashboard. Similarly, the probe clip is clamped on the negative pole. This time, we'll measure the CK, D, R, and C signals. The frequencies and amplitudes of the three signals CK, D, and C are the same. Let's start measuring. Attention, each time we test the signal waveform, we need to press the test button of the test fixture, because the fixture outputs the signal for only about 10 seconds. Remove the probe casing. Similarly, before we start measuring the waveform, we need to adjust the waveform based on the CK signal. This is its waveform. Let's measure the D signal's waveform. Here's the C signal. The R signal has a different amplitude and frequency, so it needs separate adjustments. Okay, here is its waveform. Well, that's the waveform demonstration of this oscilloscope. Thank you for watching.